In 1991, the executive committee passed a resolution accepting the health care proxy, in which was included the clause for organ donation. And of course they accepted it because they accepted the concept of brainstem death, because they couldn't have accepted the healthcare proxy without accepting brainstem death. And that became the official policy of the RCA. And the whole question of brainstem death was discussed at the executive committee meeting, because of course the rabbis asked the question, how can you donate organs? And that's the answer we gave them. And it became official policy of the RCA. And as I say, there was a very strong campaign against it. They got Rabbi Aaron Soloveitchik Zatzal to write a tshuva that his brother never accepted brainstem death, which unfortunately I had to contest, because not that I didn't trust Rabbi Aaron Soloveitchik, but Rabbi Aaron Soloveitchik probably spoke to the Rav before the Harvard criteria were established. I'm sure he didn't discuss it with him afterwards. But there was one gadol in Eretz Yisrael who was against it, and that was Rabbi Shlomo Zalman Auerbach Zatzal, who, when we performed, I don't want to take the time to go into this in detail, but when we performed a certain experiment, and he sent one of his people to observe it, he changed his mind about brainstem death, and he wrote a tshuva which is in existence. It was printed in Asia, in the medical magazine of Anasia, where he changed his mind about brainstem death, and he said, yes, brainstem death is a definition of death. Rav Moshe wrote a subsequent tshuva.
Did you have any personal interaction with Rav Moshe Feinstein on this issue?
No, Rabbi Tendler did.